Welcome back. During this lecture, we'll cover market value measures. Market value measures are helpful to analyze how well corporations' common stocks are performing in the stock exchange. These measures are also helpful to evaluate management's performance in terms of creating or destroying the value of the corporation or the value of the corporation's shareholders. So if the management can increase the common stock value of the company, we can say that managements are doing well. If the management is not capable of improving corporation's stock value in terms against its earnings or book value of equity, we can say that managements are not skilled enough to create value for the company's shareholders. There are two popular ratios to analyze the market value of the company, or simply to analyze company's share price. These are price to earnings ratio and price to book ratio. Let's look at price to earning ratio. Price to earning ratio compares a company's share price with its earning per share. So the formula of price to earning ratio is equal to market price per share divided by earnings per share, or simply EPS. For example, if a price earning ratio of a company is 15, it tells us that investors are willing to pay $15 against $1 of earning per share. So a higher price to earning ratio indicates that investors are confident with the growth prospect of the business. Now we'll look at price to book ratio. This ratio compares the company's share price with the company's book value per share. Price to earning ratio is equal to market price per share divided by equity book value per share. Equity book value per share means value of the equity based on the company's balance sheet. Here, equity book value per share is equal to equity reported on the balance sheet divided by number of shares outstanding, or simply total number of shares of the business which are trading in the stock exchanges. In general, if price to book ratio is greater than 1, it indicates that investors are confident that the company is worth more in the long run. And if the ratio is less than 1, it indicates that company's managers are destroying the value of the company, or company's managers have destroyed the value of the business. That's all about this lecture. In our next lecture, we'll cover horizontal analysis of financial statements.